recognizing member for Kootenai West.
Last fall, we asked the Minister of Children and Family Development why she scheduled the release of her response to the Paige report at 3 p.m. on the day of the federal election. The Premier denied this was the case. She told the media, and I quote, "The report was ready to be released. The children advocate supported that release, so that's when it went out." Well, Madam Speaker, that wasn't at all accurate. According to newly released government emails, it's clear that political staff in government deliberately hurried the release of the report to ensure that it came out on election day. Honourable Speaker, my question is to the Minister. Why did she try to bury her response to the Paige report on election day?
Minister of Children and Family Development.
Well, thank you, Madam Speaker. And to reiterate what I said back in October, we've been trying to get the report out for some time. In order to do so, protocol dictated that we brief the representative. We had had briefings scheduled weeks prior to the 19th that her office postponed. Eventually, the representative agreed with us that we would go ahead and release our response so that it could be out in the public domain for discussion and discussion here in this House. She even went so far, Madam Speaker, as to provide a quote for the news release that said, "I am buoyed to see that MCFD and government have begun to grapple with these important issues and that progress will be improved outcomes for these youth, far too many of whom are Aboriginal children who have endured incredible journeys of hardship and who deserve our full attention," said the representative for children and youth, Mary Ellen Terpel-Lafond. Government has also released details of its plan today, which is a step toward improved transparency. Madam Speaker, we released the report when we did because the House was sitting and we wanted the opportunity to get this out and respond if there were questions, Madam Speaker. I held a media availability the next day to take questions about the report and the timing, Madam Speaker, and what we're asking, what the members opposite are asking about today is, again, the timing of a report from 4 months ago.
Member for Kootenai West on a supplemental.
Again, Madam Speaker, the Minister is just not accurate with her information. The House was not sitting on October 19th. And according to government emails, the report was scheduled for release on October 21st, when the House was sitting. According to government emails, staff suddenly, with no explanation, revised the plan, moved up the release date, and panicked to ensure it was out at 3 p.m. on election day. But the Premier insists it's all just business as usual. I guess it is business as usual for a government that has completely lost its moral compass.
Honourable Speaker,
we're talking about a report,
question,
a release about the death of an Aboriginal teen. So can the Minister explain why, to the House, why she seems more concerned with media strategies and political calculations than she does with protecting the most vulnerable children in our society?
Minister of Children and Family Development.
Let's talk about some facts, Madam Speaker. Since the release on October 19th, the members have asked me exactly zero times about the response that government has made to this report. They have sent me zero pieces of correspondence asking me about government's response to the Paige report. They have requested zero briefings about our response to the Paige report. Madam Speaker, in 4 months, since a report was our response to the representative's very thorough report on an extremely tragic death, Madam Speaker, 4 months and there has been absolutely zero interest from that side of the House. And still today, Madam Speaker, I hear zero questions on content of the report, on what we're doing as a government, Madam Speaker. Just about timing, Madam Speaker. And that's interesting, that commentary today, Madam Speaker, because, Madam Speaker, as the representative said on the day after the report was released, there is never a bad day to come forward and accept this and start moving forward. That was a quote from the representative on the 20th of October. And the suggestion that somehow it would have been better, Madam Speaker, to release the report 2 days later, as originally scheduled, Madam Speaker, during the aftermath of an extremely exciting federal election, when the media was preoccupied with analyzing the results of that, Madam Speaker, is an interesting theory for me to discover, Madam Speaker. But surely, Madam Speaker, it says a lot about where the opposition's priorities are, because it certainly isn't on the kids.